Hunting the Menu is proudly brought to you by the Sporting Shooters Association of Australia. Join us at SSAA.org.au.
G'day and welcome to Hunting the Menu. While I try and catch lunch, here's a sneak peek of what's on today's show. Boys, what do you got there for me today?
Very exciting stuff. We're off to the Med.
Off to the Med?
Yeah.
I hope they're not the medical centre.
No. The Mediterranean Sea.
Oh, Mediterranean squid rolls and taverna goat.
Yeah, beautiful.
I can kind of work out the Mediterranean squid rolls, but this taverna goat, mate, explain it to me.
Well, the taverna, of course, is a Greek bar restaurant.
Yeah.
And they put on a taverna dish, which is like the dish the family would all sit around and eat. They'll take a pair of legs and they normally roast them off on top of big robust vegetables, onions, sweet potato, all of that sort of thing.
Okay.
And then people sit at long tables and eat this taverna meal.
Beautiful.
As opposed to eating like a hamburger or fish and chips or something like that.
Right, yeah.
So that's what that is. It's a big robust family goat-based dish.
Sounds fantastic. So Shane, the squid. Get that local, mate, you reckon?
Yeah, it might scoot down to JB, mate. Have a bit of a poke around down there, I think.
Okay, down to Jervis, yeah. What about the goat, mate? Where do you reckon we'll get those?
Mate, there's quite a few goats around here, so we shouldn't have to travel too far from home.
All right, Doss. I'm going to get the boat ready, and we'll see you in a few days or so.
Yeah, well, you and your boat, you know what I think about your boat.
Yeah, I know. I will take you out one day.
Yeah, right.
I'll bring you some squid.
Yeah, oh, really?
Yeah.
That's a consolation prize.
And you can cook it up for me.
Oh, no, I'll leave that to Shane. You'll have a good feed down there, and I'll miss that as well.
Jervis Bay is a fishing paradise with something for just about everyone. From squidding to salmon off the many beaches, a flatty on the sandbanks, kingies, tuna, and it's one of the few places in the world where you can land marlin from the rocks. Now, squid may not fight like a marlin, more like a shopping bag, but they taste great and are plentiful in the bay. The bag limit is 20, but land half a dozen good ones and you'll have enough for a tasty feed. Shane, how beautiful is this morning, huh?
Yeah, beautiful morning, mate. Bit overcast.
Yeah.
Quite good for squid.
Yeah, it'll be fantastic. I mean, getting up at 5:30 this morning is quite easy when you're coming out here like this, isn't it?
It is, mate.
We're not going to go too far today, are we?
No, well, we don't really have to, mate. There's that much habitat around here for squid. It's not funny, so we don't have to go far at all. All these boats and all the moorings, all the growth that attaches itself to the ropes, starts a food chain.
Yeah, yeah.
And the squid love to hang out under the boats in the shade.
Yeah. Yeah, looking down here, look, there's just weed everywhere. It's just like...
Yeah, it's a lot of seagrass, and that's where all the juvenile fish and prawns hide, and that's what the squid love to eat, so...
Yeah.
Shallow water.
Well, Jervis Bay is, you know, renowned for its squid fishing, you know. It's just such a pristine place, you know. It's perfect. The waters are generally crystal clear.
Yeah,
so.
Exactly. It's a massive hatchery and a breeding ground for a lot of fish and prawns and crustaceans, so...
Yeah.
I reckon it should be good.
All right, we look like we're over some good weed now. We want
to... Yeah, a little bit darker here, so...
Yep.
We might start here, eh? Work our way into the boats.
I'll grab a rod and we'll get set up. You're on, Shane?
Yeah, I've got a little one.
Oh, he's just blown his ink
He's just blown his ink, which is good.
That's good, won't dirty the boat up.
I don't know if we'll eat this one or keep him for kingy or dewy bait. But
a mate of mine calls them kingfish lolly.
Lollipops. Yeah, nice little squid.
Drop him in. There we go. Nice work, mate. I think I'm on here.
Hey.
Yep.
Finally.
Right on the surface this one's hit. You got to keep the drag not too tight, because if you keep it too tight, you tear it clean out of their skin. He's coming up. He's not a bad one. It's taken a while, mate, hasn't it?
You're not wrong, mate. Just over that broken patch of reef there, eh?
Yep. I'm actually going to bring him down to you.
Yep.
And see if you can lift him out for me. Looks like I only just had him, mate.
You did, mate, but... Just enough is good enough.
Yeah, no.
Now we'll just try and get him in your boat without
threatening. Straighten the live well. Beautiful.
Job done.
Okay.
Should we do another drift over that?
Let's do a drift. And we don't need too many. I think we'll get a good feed out of that. Now, we drifted around for a while, and I actually had a pink jig on. I changed it to this brown one. Within 5 minutes, I was on. Now, with the pink one, we might have been going for about an hour, and we had nothing. It just shows that if you change sometimes the colour of the lure, you know, you can come up trumps.
We're just going to make a quick sort of a toasted bread roll today. Very simple, very easy, again with things that you normally take with you or very accessible. So it's not going to be overly difficult. We'll just run through it quickly. First thing we're going to do is cut up some veggies. So a bit of green capsicum and a bit of red capsicum. Not too much. Always do too much of this and it ends up overfilling the bread rolls. So just a little bit. We're going to do the same thing with the red capsicum. Nice bit of sort of Mediterranean sort of flavour to it. We're also going to knock up a little bit of red onion. These have been in the esky too. Good thing to keep onions in the esky or in a fridge. Stops you from crying when you're peeling them. Righto, so that's our veggies done. We're now going to do our squid tubes. So they've been cleaned, ready to go. So we're just going to split them down the side, cut them in half pretty much. And that way, and again. And we're just going to score the squid so it curls up. Everybody's seen how squid curls up, so we're just going to do that down the side. We don't want to cut right through it. So we're just scoring all the way down, turn it around, score down the other way. And we're just going to cut it into a couple of pieces. That way, if it's a bit rough, it's not really going to matter. It'll cook up quite nice. You might wonder why I use a wok a fair bit. In these circumstances, they heat up very, very quickly with gas burners like we've got now. Sometimes big fry pans take a long time to heat up. You can throw food in there, it retards the heat. It takes a lot longer to heat up, you end up boiling the food. When we're cooking in a wok, it's very direct heat and very quick, so just a simple thing. First thing I'm gonna do is just drop these bread rolls in a bit of this oil. It's just a French stick with the middle hollowed out, very simple. Just gonna let them heat up a bit, crisp up a bit, and they'll absorb some of the oil. Doesn't take too long. We're also going to start with cooking our vegetables before we put our squid in, because we don't want to overcook our squid. All right, so our bread rolls have got a nice little bit of color to them, then we've absorbed some oil. We're just going to let the wok heat up again till it lightly starts to smoke. And we're going to throw our veggies in. Probably just give them a couple of minutes to cook down a bit. Really smell that garlic oil coming through now with the capsicum and onion. These are going to be good. I think I put too much in as usual, but anyway, we'll make it work. Righto, so there we go. Veggies are done, I reckon. We've got enough heat back in the wok. We're going to put our calamari in. Don't want to cook this for very long at all. Hopefully we can keep enough heat in the wok. Wind's making life a bit difficult, but anyway. Got a little bit more of a drizzle of olive oil, some garlic. All right. Now that this is caramelising up nicely, we're just going to dress our bread rolls. It's come along quite well. Not too much green stuff because we don't want to take up too much room. Cherry tomatoes, quickly, cut up a couple of them. They don't roll off the ute. Don't need too many. Now we're just going to quickly finish this off. This is starting to colour up really nicely and smells great. Just a little bit of honey soy sauce. That'll just put a little bit of salt into it and give it a little bit of sweetness too with the honey. Not too much, just a little bit. Whoa, that looks good. Righto, so that's about our calamari done. We'll just dish up our rolls. The wind's picking up, hopefully it doesn't blow it off the truck. Righto, here we go. Smells unreal. Looks pretty good too. Making a bit of a mess, but anyway. Right, we're just going to finish it with a quick drizzle of mayo, and then we're done. And I suppose it'll be about that time for Corey to turn up. There we go.
All right, mate, I think I heard my name.
As always, turn up at the perfect time.
You know, I'm just lurking in the background waiting for you to finish this.
How about we go halves in this one to start with, eh?
Yeah.
Ready?
Yes. Beautiful. How good is that, hey?
Oh, I hope it tastes right. Looks good.
It certainly does, mate. That's from the ocean, what, an hour and a half ago?
2 hours. It took me a bit longer than expected.
Yeah.
I had to clean the boat and everything.
Yeah.
How is it?
Mate, it's never bad. I just don't think you can beat, like, fresh calamari, you know? Out of the ocean, onto a sandwich like this and boom. Just better. So, mate, our next adventure is out after a couple of goats.
I think so. That's the next on the list.
Yep.
Yep. Change of scenery.
Yeah, I love goat. It's beautiful.
It is. Yeah. It's pretty nice, but.
Yeah. No, this is fantastic.
The thing that I really have enjoyed is the people. We're like a big family.
In a day's training, I might go through anywhere between 300 and 500, maybe possibly 600 rounds.
I see that firearms are an essential tool for the farmer.
First shot I ever did, it felt amazing. I felt glad that I actually did something that I felt passionate about.
Shane, check this place out. There must be some fantastic history here.
You're not wrong, Cor. Toshi's been here a while.
Yeah. This is back when the farmers used to sort of cut a life out for themselves.
Yeah.
There were no amenities, no nothing.
Good luck to them. They did well, I reckon.
Mate, I found your mattress for the night.
Oh, technology, inner spring and everything. You hear that? And this?
What do you got there?
Insulation. Horsehair.
Horsehair? Wow. Yeah.
Horsehair insulation.
Wow. Look at the old bottles and the old tins left here.
Old pair of boots, yeah, they'd probably fit you too.
Yeah, I might need them a bit later.
They look nearly 100 years old.
You could write some great stories on places like this, couldn't you?
Yeah, they're just great places to be, mate, and have a look at the history.
That's fantastic. Look, we're out here to hunt goats.
Yep.
What's our plan?
As the afternoon's cooling down like it is now, mate, hopefully the goats will start feeding out of the thicker timber line and that behind us, out of this more open country here.
Okay.
It's a bit more green, as you can see at the moment. Springtime, it's beautiful country, so hopefully we should be right.
It's the middle of the day, a little bit of time, so...
We have got a bit of time, mate. Breeze is alright, though. It's a bit cool, so they might come out a bit earlier.
Shane, check out these over here.
Oh, the cars.
They might come in handy.
How old do you reckon they are?
Oh, they look pretty old, Shane. I'd say the cottage is a little bit older, though.
Probably, mate. Have a go at them, mate. Unreal.
Yeah, you reckon we could salvage a couple of them?
Well,
so taking off a bit of spotlighting tonight, maybe? Look, this one's already got the roof cut off.
Unfortunately, anyone that knows me and my mechanical skills, I don't think we've got much hope at all, to be honest.
What do you reckon? You reckon we get it started?
Well, it's actually got a block in it.
Really?
Yeah, one, two.
No, probably just needs a bit of oil.
Six cylinder, even, have a go.
Couple of wheels. Still have a go on in no time.
Not with me, mate, unfortunately. No chance at all.
Feral goat numbers range in the vicinity of around 3 million and cause major environmental and pastoral damage, costing farmers alone around 25 million in losses. In recent times, farmers have had a small win with an increase in demand for these environmental lawnmowers, making it profitable to round them up and ship them off to market. Young animals are perfect for the table and are similar in taste to lamb.
Shane, I take it that's as far as we can take our buggy. She's not the most stealth thing.
Yeah, we'll leave it here, mate, and we'll just dawdle over the hill here and get set up down this gully here in this nice open country they've got around us here, and the goats have been sort of hanging out through this scrub line over the back, so usually this time of the day they start feeding out and hopefully they'll come to us.
All right, Shane, let's go and get Dorsey's goat and you're on lead.
All right, mate, no worries. Beautiful looking country this time of year, isn't
it? It certainly is. Well, Shane, we might not have to wait after all.
No, we're not going to have to. Well, look at it, mate. There's quite a few fed out down the creek here already. I'd say that wind that's coming down the gully has kept the sound from the buggy over the hill and hasn't alerted them at all. And there's quite a few up the back here amongst the tree line, and there's more down here over the other side of the creek under the trees in the shade there. And there's quite a few nice young animals down here too.
Fantastic. Well, as long as that wind stays on my right shoulder, we should be right.
I think it will, mate. So, yeah, we'll be able to nosey on down here a little bit further and get a bit closer and get a nice young animal.
Fantastic.
We should be right.
So we're going to have to be a bit quieter now.
Yeah, well, there's quite a few goats, and you've got to be a little bit careful with all the nannies that are sort of sitting around now down there, and they're the ones that sort of pick up movement and stuff mainly, so we'll just, yeah.
So they're on high alert?
Yeah, they are, because when they've got young with them, they're sort of always looking after their kids.
Shane, there's a couple of big billies coming out of the creek down here.
There's quite a few billies down there, mate.
They'd be good for the export market.
Yeah, indeed. It's certainly jumped up in price. They're bringing good money at the moment, so we're only here to take a nice couple of meat animals for ourselves, and we'll leave the rest, and I'm pretty sure the local farmer's going to round them up and truck them off shortly.
All right, we better get in position then.
Yeah, we'll go down and get one, eh? All right, just staying behind me, mate. We'll just keep a bit of a narrow profile, and we'll just duck down here in the edge of the shade and get set up and...
Okay, that helps us make us look a little bit more like one.
Yeah, we're staying in the shade too, mate. We'll just get set up here and try and take a nice shot. We'll just sneak down towards this edge here a bit further. I think we're going to be a little bit closer to him.
Maybe a bit more exposed, Shane, in the sun here.
We will be. And that wind's just changed too. Can you feel that wind change?
Yeah.
That might not be very good for us. We'll just duck down here now. Little tan one, mate, just coming out of the creek now.
Uh-huh.
See?
Yep.
They're a bit agitated now, I think, with that wind change. The nannies have picked up our scent a bit further up. You can see them looking up the creek.
Okay, yep, that one's good.
Yeah, take him when you can, mate.
Straight down, mate.
Nice shot, mate. Nice and clean, excellent. Wow, look at them all go.
Well, there's a lot of them. There's about 50, 60 in that pack.
Yeah, still coming out of the creek.
I like it when it's clean like that, straight down.
No, very good,
job
mate.
Done.
Very nice. Well done. Oh, very good.
All right.
Well done, mate.
Part of the job done.
Yeah, that's it.
Let's go and get the buggy and work out how we get across that creek.
Yeah, mate, we'll get down there to him pretty quick and get him dressed up and packed onto iced. A few blowies around this time of year, and we don't want to lose the meat. Very good.
All right, let's go.
When I'm not hunting, I'm thinking about hunting. It's on my mind because it's in my blood. When the hunt calls, my TC Venture points the way. Accurate, reliable, proven. Until there's no more ground to cover and no more stories to tell. When you're a TC Venture hunter, the hunt never ends.
The boys have brought me two lovely little goat legs, and I'm going to cook them taverna style. Well, it's a Greek thing, you know what I mean? First of all, we're going to start off by crushing up some garlic cloves and putting them into this bowl here, along with a few spices. I'm going to crush the garlic cloves in. Nicely done. Can't beat fresh garlic. Don't be tempted to use bottled garlic or dried garlic, because fresh garlic really is the prime mover for this sort of thing. That'll add us a little bit of weight. Here's the sumac. Here is the paprika. Going to give it a little bit of spice, not much. It's quite sweet, that paprika. The ginger will give it a bit of heat along with the garlic. And the fennel seeds will give it that beautiful flavor that we're looking for that makes it a bit Greek. On top of that, a little bit of olive oil. A grind of pepper. All of this is going to be rubbed all over the goats just to keep them a little bit moist in the oven. Thing with goat is, it's lean like kangaroo, very healthy, presents a little bit like lamb, but less fat, and that means that it's a little bit difficult to cook with. So let's get this onto the goats, so they're ready. That's easy, just rub it in. Doesn't matter if it's a bit lumpy, it's going to be. You're aiming to cover up the goats a bit, and then make sure that this seeps through. It'll help brown them off as well, so they'll look a bit more interesting. Now we can put those to one side, and now we can concentrate on these fellas. What we're going to do is cook the goat on a bed of vegetables. Now some of these are winter-style vegetables, and some of them are summer-style vegetables. It doesn't matter what season you're in. These fennel bulbs you can get quite often all year round. And they're going to impart their flavors while they cook gently in the olive oil for about an hour or so, and then we'll pull it all out, and then when we've got it out, we'll add about half a bottle of decent white wine, and that'll allow us to steam off the legs without them getting too dry. So we're going to cut all our vegetables in half, and we're going to put them in the pan as a good bed for these legs. Number one, they, and when we put the foil over, will create steam that will keep these legs really moist. And number two, they'll form the vegetables for us to eat with the meat. Very important. Now, these beetroot, really beautiful. They're going to color the sauce, nice red. They're going to add really earthy flavor, which is what you want with a country style meal like this, and with goat. I'm also going to throw a couple of chilies in, even though we've got ginger and garlic in the paste. This will add a little bit of heat to the juices and to the vegetables. So our vegetables have had 10 minutes in the oven and they are really relaxed and started to soften up. Now what we want to do is to bring into play fresh herbs to complement the dry herbs we've already rubbed down the goat with. So here's a nice piece of rosemary, the delicious thyme from the garden, which is so aromatic at the moment, and of course bay leaves. Bay leaves add that undercurrent that sometimes you don't even know is there. Now, on top of that, we're going to take the juice of a lemon. Half of it's going to go over our goat, the juice of half a lemon, over the goat legs, over the vegetables, and just toss it in there. Roasted lemon, absolutely delicious. We're going to put a little lid on it out of alfoil so that they steam away in there and retain their juiciness, which is what we want. We don't want them to dry out.
course. That looks fantastic, mate.
No, good too.
Let's have a bit.
You want to taste a bit?
Yeah, yeah, before we get out there, because it wouldn't be right to take it out there.
No, that's right. Here we go. Oh, look at that. It's falling apart.
Here we go.
A little bit of shank on there.
My pleasure. Beautiful and tender.
I'll take a little bit off here. Is it tender?
That's beautiful.
Yeah. Come on, let's get it outside and we'll serve it up properly.
Are you going to take it out?
Yeah, I'll take it out. You can bring out the other stuff.
I'll set out some cutlery and some plates. Someone could come back and give me a hand with Tom there, though.
Cool, I need the door open.
How many are we with the crew? 17?
Yeah, no, the crew's there. Let's get this out. Oh, hang on, it's open. We're good. Right. Yeah, we're good.
All right. Don't mind that. It's quite a nice flavour.
Oh, here comes the dog. Look out.
What are we talking about?
You just talked every time.
We're all talking too much.
Oh, for Christ's sakes, we do it all the time.
Put it here. Tastes bloody good. Okay.
It tastes all right.
Yeah, let's go. It's got some kick.
It's the leg of a goat, so.
Hunting the Menu, proudly brought to you by the Sporting Shooters Association of Australia. Join us at sssaa.org.au.